Thank you, Nathan. We are exactly 1 week away from the midterm election. To make sure you're prepared for election day, KVUE has launched Vote Texas Face-Off. You can catch it here on midday every Tuesday. Weighing in today are Ed Espinoza and Matt Mackowiak. Ed Espinoza is the executive director of Progress Texas, an organization advocating for progressive ideals and policies. He has more than 20 years of experience providing strategic communication counsel for 50 campaigns and served as the Western State's director at the Democratic National Committee. Matt Mackowiak is a political and communications consultant who is also president of Potomac Strategy Group. He served in senior roles for two U.S. senators and then Governor George W. Bush. Mackowiak currently serves as chairman of the Travis County Republican Party. All right, guys, so I think one of the big things that we're talking about today is President Donald Trump saying, yesterday we saw that show where he said he wants to end birthright citizenship for people who are born in the U.S. but not to non-citizens or to undocumented immigrants. First of all, is this political strategy, Matt?
Well, I think partly you have to wonder, anytime something's announced close to an election, it's probably being done with politics in mind. That said, there's also this caravan of thousands of migrants who are traveling from Guatemala, apparently, to the southern border of the United States. And so I think from his standpoint, from President Trump's standpoint, he's trying to think about the magnets that are in our system that are drawing illegal immigrants to the country. And if you can get rid of those incentives, you can hopefully get control of illegal immigration. Now, there are huge questions about whether his executive order would be constitutional. It certainly wouldn't take effect immediately. I'm sure there would be lawsuits, would likely go to the Supreme Court. We're talking about a long-term fight ultimately, but the Supreme Court's never ruled on the constitutionality of the 14th Amendment, and that's what's at question here. And so there is an interesting legal debate that's been going on for years about the question of birthright citizenship, whether it's constitutional, and we have to think about if we want to reduce illegal immigration, which every American should want to reduce illegal immigration, what are we willing to do to try to achieve that?
Ed, when we think about this, a lot of things have been tied to politics in the terms of if the president throws out an idea of something he wants to do and Democrats try very hard to shut it down, some of his supporters then just get more upset with the Democratic Party. Do you think that that could come into play here?
Yeah, I mean, this is all politics. Look, the only magnet involved here is Trump trying to pull people away from the issues that are dragging his poll numbers down and towards something else. The whole issue of birthright citizenship, look, it's one that's been in the Constitution for a very long time, and it's not one that people are really clamoring for right now. By the way, I'd be curious to see what Ted Cruz would think about birthright citizenship, considering he wasn't born in this country. So you have conflicts all over this case. My parents weren't citizens when I was born here. This affects so many different people. But the real issue here is that Trump is trying to cause a diversion because he's trying to take away health care. He's trying to lobby against pre-existing conditions. He had a terrible response to another mass shooting this weekend and then was tweeting about baseball shortly afterwards. This is nothing more than a diversionary tactic. He can't change the Constitution and he knows that. But he's doing this because he's playing games and he's trying to cause some sort of a smokescreen. He's very good at it, but I think people are seeing past it this time.
You know, you brought up Senator Cruz, and of course, we cannot forget the big election that he is in. New Quinnipiac poll coming out yesterday saying that his lead over Congressman Beto O'Rourke getting a little bit smaller, went from 9 to 5. Do you think that O'Rourke is closing in?
Well, I do think he's closing in, and you know, not only are the poll numbers kind of coming back to show this race is getting tighter, but something else that we're seeing here is that with all of these new voters turning out, is that they're not always going to show up in polling data. If you have non-traditional voters, unconventional voters who don't show up in midterm elections, those aren't ones that are going to show up in a likely voter screen. We're seeing that in a lot of places, a lot of millennial voters, a lot of Generation X voters. A lot of voters who are from communities of color that don't participate in midterm elections are showing up this year. That should give a sign of optimism to Beto O'Rourke and progressives like myself.
But Matt, there's a big deficit the Democrats have to make up. When we look at Texas voting numbers, about 1 million more Republicans show up than Democrats.
Yeah, that's right. I mean, Beto O'Rourke has a math problem in Texas. I don't see a path to victory for him. I never have. I've said that for months and months and months. There are times when this race has become closer, times where the race has gone in Cruz's direction. I think polling right now is pretty suspect in general. More people are moving towards cell phones. It is hard to figure out exactly who's going to turn out. We've only had 7 or 8% of the people who've early voted have no vote history that are brand new voters. And I think the O'Rourke campaign is thinking, well, we're getting all of those votes, and that's probably not likely. You probably have new movers that have just moved to Texas recently, many of whom would be Republicans. So look, it's close. Is it close enough that Beto can win? I don't think so. Could Beto overperform, and could that have down ballot effect in key races around the state? That is possible. I still think Cruz is likely to win by a 7 to 9 point margin, but obviously we have to see what happens 7 days from now.
Absolutely, and of course that vote going to be up to you guys. Remember, early voting ends on Friday. Election Day is November 6th. We thank you both for joining us this morning.
Thanks.
Good to be here.
All right.